This interactive simulation uses the Peng-Robinson equation state to calculate pressure volume isotherms. And then what is shown are two isotherms. The blue curve corresponds to liquid phase composition that we're interested in. Of course, it's over the range of liquid and vapor, but we set the liquid phase composition here. And so that means we select the point on the curve. The pressure in this case is determined from Raoult's law. We certainly could use a few gas these in the equation state, but for simplicity, we use Raoult's law. We fix the liquid composition. We use Raoult's law to calculate the vapor composition and the pressure. The green line then corresponds to the isotherm for that vapor composition, and we're connecting this liquid composition, which is in equilibrium with this vapor composition. And the idea is to demonstrate that we can actually use the Peng-Robinson equation of state to determine equilibrium, but we have to have a separate isotherm for each composition. We can change the temperature of both isotherms, and we can change the composition of the liquid phase and calculate new equilibrium conditions. Displayed over here are the values for the mole fraction, 0.38, which we fixed, and then the mole fraction, the vapor phase, and then the pressure that we calculate. Notice this is a log scale on both the pressure scale and the volume scale. So let's look at this interactive simulation and see what happens as we change these variables. So here's the interactive simulation. And as we change the temperature, for example, then both curves change. And we're still showing this liquid composition now, 0.37, equilibrium with the vapor composition, changes as we change the temperature. We can also change the mole fraction in the liquid phase. And there's a corresponding change in the vapor phase. And so the isotherms are generated for the mixture for a fixed composition. And this gives us a little better understanding that we can actually use equations of state to look at vapor-liquid equilibrium. In this case, for ideal solution, but certainly for non-ideal solutions if we have the appropriate information built into the equation.